In this video, I'm going to show you how network switches use MAC addresses to do their job, which of course is switching. And I'll also cover how attackers use MAC addresses to attack a network switch. And then we'll wrap up by looking at some security measures that we can put in place to help prevent those attacks. Now, if you're new to MAC addresses, do make sure you've watched the previous video in this series, which gives an introduction to MAC addresses, and I'll leave the link below in the description. Now, if you find this video helpful, don't forget to help the video, help it beat the YouTube algorithm by giving it a like, share it, leave a comment below, and subscribe to the IT Taster channel for more content. Let's get into the video. Network switches don't just connect network devices. They learn and they make decisions where to forward frames. And this is what makes them so super efficient. And all of this is done using MAC addresses. Let me show you how. In this example, PC1 needs to communicate with PC2. A frame is sent from PC1's network interface card to the switch. And then comes the cool part. The network switch is going to examine the source MAC address of the frame sent by PC1 to learn its MAC address and the port that it was received on. The switch then stores PC1's MAC address and the port number, port 1, in its MAC address table. Now, a MAC address table is also referred to as a CAM table, and it's best to think of it as a sort of database if you like. Now, the switch also examines the destination address of the frame sent from PC1 to determine where to send it. If there isn't an entry in the MAC address table for the destination MAC address and port number, the switch sends the frame out of all ports, except the port that it came in on. But this is less efficient. When PC2 examines the frame and it matches its MAC address, it replies to PC1 by sending a frame. The switch again examines the source MAC address of the frame sent from PC2. It learns it and it stores it in its MAC address table. The switch needs to forward the frame from PC2, so it checks its MAC address table for the destination MAC address. This time there is an entry and the frame is sent out of port 1. Let's just take a look at one more example. In this example, PC3 needs to communicate with PC2. And the same thing happens again. The switch examines the source MAC address. It updates its MAC address table. The switch needs to forward the frame, so it checks its MAC address table. And there is an entry for PC2's MAC address and the port number associated with it. The frame is then sent out of port 2 to PC2. And this is how a switch learns, but in reality, network devices do generate a lot of traffic communicating with network services, so a switch is able to learn very quickly and also update itself regularly. Now that we've learned how network switches use MAC addresses to make decisions where to forward frames, let's now move on to take a look at how attackers use this functionality to attack a network switch. MAC address flooding, also known as a CAM overflow attack, is carried out when an attacker connects to a network switch and uses a software tool to continuously bombard the switch with thousands of frames per second containing random source MAC addresses. Now, the network switch begins adding the source MAC addresses to its MAC address table to learn them in order to make forwarding decisions. However, a switch's MAC address table is only able to store a specific number of MAC addresses before it runs out of resources and becomes full. Now, when the MAC address table is full, the switch floods any frames it receives out of all ports. A successful MAC flooding attack causes a switch to operate like an old legacy network hub, and this is one reason why we don't use them anymore. An attacker is then able to capture traffic within the local LAN or VLAN and also launch a man-in-the-middle attack. And also keep in mind, a MAC address table attack can also spread to other switches. Now, there are some security measures that we can put in place to help prevent Mac flooding attacks. First of all, make sure some physical security is in place. Lock network cabinets and ideally locate them in secure areas. Disable unused network ports. And one important technical configuration that we're going to look at next, enable port security. Port security is a very important feature. A port can be manually configured for a specific MAC address, or the switch can be configured to dynamically learn the MAC addresses of the devices connected to each port. Now, in this example, port security is enabled and manually configured. So when PC1 is connected, the switch checks PC1's source MAC address against its configuration for port 1. PC1's MAC address matches and it's permitted to connect. And again, when PC2 is connected, the switch checks PC2's source MAC address against its configuration for port 2. PC2's MAC address again matches and it too is permitted to connect. But when the attacker connects to the switch with an unknown MAC address that's not configured, the switch port, in this case a Cisco switch, will shut down by default, preventing the attacker from connecting to the network. Now, because port security enables us to limit the number of learned MAC addresses, should an attacker successfully connect to the network and attempt to launch a MAC flooding attack and bombard the switch with thousands of random source MAC addresses, the port will simply shut down. But a word of warning though, limiting the number of MAC addresses for uplink ports to other switches will disable those ports. Well, that brings us to the end of this session. Do join me in the next video where we'll learn about some of the challenges we face when tracking down an attacker by their MAC address. So, as always, thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.